Yo, look, I get it. Gaming isn't exactly the most strenuous activity you could be doing. The E in esports doesn't exactly mean extreme. I'm not here to act like you're putting yourself in danger every time you load up Call of Duty. But it's my opinion that the general public's idea of what a gamer is wildly outdated. The gaming industry is huge, and it's not just one type of person that's making that happen. Some of you are probably athletic, and some of you aren't. Some of you probably look like the stereotypical gamer, and I'm willing to bet that there are those of you that probably surprise your coworkers and your friends when you tell them that you like the game as well. When I explained my idea to start a YouTube channel that taught stretches and exercises to gamers to deal with some of the common aches and pains that we deal with, most people thought the idea was pretty cool. But there are some that laughed as if the idea of a gamer having pain from gaming was ridiculous. But you know what? F*** those people. My hands hurt sometimes, man. My name is Franco, and today we're going to be talking about hand, wrist, and forearm pain and what we can do to make it better. If you're new here, I created this channel to combine what I do for work with my love for gaming. By day, I work as a physical therapy tech in the Army. When I come home, I stream on Twitch where I play a variety of games. Usually at this point in the video, I explain why you might be having these sorts of pains as it relates to gaming, but for this one, I think it might be pretty obvious. Whether it be a controller or a keyboard and mouse, we put our hands in some weird positions that aren't always comfortable. Multiply that by hundreds or thousands of hours, and it's pretty easy to see why you might be feeling like crap. Luckily, these stretches are pretty easy to do, so you can do them at your desk, on the couch, in your bed, on the toilet. I don't care, I don't judge. So let's get to work. A little bit of pain is to be expected. Sometimes stretching just kind of hurts. What I like to tell my patients is, if you do something and it hurts, but that pain goes away within 30 seconds to a minute, well then that's fine, that's okay. That's pain you should probably work through. But if you do something and it hurts in an hour, or it's still hurting the next day, that's too much, you're doing something wrong, stop it. We want to stretch, and that might hurt, but we don't want to make it worse. When you push yourself into a stretch, you want to do it gently, not just explode into it. There is no magic number when it comes to stretching. Generally, we like to tell people to do it for 30 seconds to a minute. If you can't do it for 30 seconds, that's fine. There's nothing wrong with that. It just gives you a goal for the future. All right, let's learn some stretches. The thumb can move in 5 different directions, and with this first stretch, we're going to address 4 of them. Now, I'm not a huge fan of using overly complicated medical terms if I don't need to, so I'm going to explain this in a pretty simple way. The first movement will be your thumb moving forwards and backwards against your palm. So to start, go ahead and put your thumb at the side of your hand, and from here, what you're going to do is you're going to move away from your palm and back towards your palm. Go back and forth between these two positions until you feel like you've gotten a good stretch, and then switch to the second movement, which will be away from your palm and towards your palm again, but this time going to the side. This should help with any stiffness in your thumb, as well as improve the range of motion in those 4 different directions. This next one is going to address that 5th movement that I was talking about of your thumb, and we're also going to add in some extra stuff for the rest of your fingers. The first thing you're going to do is spread out all of the fingers in your hand. Next, I want you to touch your pinky to your thumb and then move back to a spread open position. When you spread open that hand, make sure that you're getting all of your fingers as wide as you can and then coming back together with that thumb and pinky. If you can't spread your fingers out like that, or if you can't bring your thumb together, instead of doing the thumb and the pinky, go down the line to your ring finger, your middle finger, your index finger, whichever is most comfortable. And then, as you get better at this, you can work your way back up until you can do that pinky and that thumb. If you're spreading your fingers nice and wide every time you reset, well then you should be getting a good stretch for the rest of your fingers, not just your thumb. There's also a good strengthening exercise within this stretch. If you touch the pinky and your thumb and really push hard together, then you can move down the hand, doing it the same way for each finger. Moving up the arm, the next thing that we're gonna stretch is our wrist. Now the wrist can move in 4 different directions, and we're gonna address all of those right now. Go ahead and extend your arm so that your palm is facing the ground. From this position, I want you to grab onto your hand and gently pull your hand down so that you get a nice stretch in your wrist. And then hold that for as long as you feel comfortable. When you're done, let go of the hand, rotate it so that it's facing up, and then do the same thing the other way. Once you're done with that, put your arm on something flat, and now we're going to address the left and right movement of the wrist. Making sure to keep your arm planted in place, what I want you to do is move at the wrist and have your hand go left and right. Go back and forth in between these two positions, again until you feel like you've gotten a good stretch. This is another stretch for your wrist, and it couldn't be simpler. Bring your hands together as if you're praying, and then pull down on your wrist while coming up with your elbows. Try as hard as you can to keep your hands in contact with each other, because sometimes as it becomes a more intense stretch, what'll tend to happen is that your wrist will start coming apart, and then you're not really gonna get as much of a stretch. So if you can only go down a certain amount before your palms start coming apart from each other, well then that's fine. Just stop before then and work on going deeper each time you do it. This last stretch is gonna be for your forearm. Your forearm can rotate in two different directions to rotate your hand. To start, we're gonna have our hand facing down and we're gonna take an overhand grip on our wrist. Make sure that you're not grabbing too high or too low. From this position, rotate your forearm so that your hand is facing in towards your body. This would be in, this would be out. We're trying to rotate this direction. So go ahead and rotate until you feel a good stretch, assisting with that hand that's grabbing your wrist. Once you feel a good stretch and you've had enough, rotate back so that your hand is facing up. Now, from this position, we're gonna take our hand and go underneath and grab onto our wrist again. We're gonna continue rotating so that the palm of our hand starts to face out, not towards the body, but out again, and stretch that forearm in this direction. Once you feel like you've gotten a good stretch, go ahead and reset to the starting position, and you're done. So if you made it this far, go ahead and give yourself a solid pain-free thumbs up. Wow, look at that. That kind of looks like the like button, doesn't it? What a coincidence. It's my goal to continue making these types of videos for different parts of the body, so if you have a request, make sure to let me know in the comments below. Otherwise, make sure to check out the different videos that I've already made. If you found this video helpful, consider sending it to a friend who's dealing with the same kind of pain. I'll think you're cool, they'll think you're a good friend, and I'm not saying that something good's gonna happen to you, but probably. If you want to see more of me, head over to Twitch, where I stream Monday, Wednesday, and Friday. I usually play a variety of games, and it's a pretty good time. If you want to send me a clip of you doing a stretch that you find particularly helpful, I'll throw it at the end of one of my videos, and I can share your social page or whatever you have to promote. Until next time, happy pain-free gaming. I'll see you in the next video.
Been sitting for so long.